Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Hello everyone, welcome back to the PL-300 exam preparation course, where we are looking at the first learning path, prepare the data. We are looking at various data sources and how we can connect to different data sources inside of Power BI. And previously we connected to a SharePoint file, and in this video we are going to cover how we can connect to a SharePoint folder. Here again, we are going to use the Connect with SharePoint folder. And if you go inside the Connect to SharePoint folder, you see that there is a folder transactions that is there within the Connect with SharePoint folder. So now we are going to connect with this transactions folder inside of Power BI. Before I actually go and connect with this transaction folder, let's see what is inside this transaction folder. So here there are two CSV files, Maven Market Transactions 1997 and Maven Market Transactions 1998. One thing to remember here is that both of these files have the identical structure. So they have the same number of columns, and the sequence of the columns is also the same. But only the only difference between these two files is that the records are different. So I'm going to go back one step, and all I need to do is that I just need to click on this area in the transactions, and all I need to do is then I have to just copy the URL from my browser. Now I'll just use this URL inside of Power BI desktop and connect to this particular folder. I'm inside the Power Query editor, and I'm going to click on the new source here, and then I'm going to click on more. Now I need to find the SharePoint folder connector. So here I can see that the SharePoint folder connector is available. So I'm going to just select this SharePoint folder connector and click on connect. After a few seconds, the SharePoint folder window would pop up. And in this area, I will now paste the URL that I just copied from the website. But I do not need to keep this entire URL. All I need to keep is that I need to look for the area where I have layout. So here I have layouts in my URL. I just need to keep the area before the layout. So anything after the layouts, I'm going to just select it, and then I'm just going to delete it. So my URL should include everything before the layout. So this is the area which I need to keep for my URL. So I'm just going to click on OK now. After a few seconds, it opens up the window where it is asking me for the credentials. And in this area, now I find a different set of options from the SharePoint file option that I saw in the previous video. So here my interest is the Microsoft account. So I'm going to click on Microsoft account, and then I'm going to click on sign in and pass the same credentials that I passed in the previous video, which are my SharePoint Microsoft credentials. Once I enter my credentials, then I'm just going to click on connect. After a few seconds, it opens up the pop-up window where you can see that I am seeing all the contents of my SharePoint directory. And I can see a lot of different files here. So all I need to do is that I just need to click on the transform data option here. And here you can see that I am seeing a query that has all the different files available in my SharePoint directory. So I just need to go towards the extreme right. I scroll towards the extreme right, and I'll find a column that says folder path. So I'm going to click on this drop down here from this folder path options, and in the search area, I'm just going to type transactions, because I know that the folder that I'm looking for is the transactions folder. So in this area, now I can find the file path where my transactions folder is placed. So I'm just going to select that particular folder path, and then I'm going to click on okay. Now I can clearly see that I have reached the folder, and I can clearly see the two files, Maven Market Transactions 1997 and 1998. So now I have been given access to the folder, and I can either select the file which is required, or I can select both the files if I want to include both the files. So what I need to do is that I just need to go in this binary area on the left where the name of the file is, and I just need to click on the area which has the blank space, and then I'm going to click on the on this area using the right click, not the left click. I'm just going to click using the right click of the mouse, and then I am going to click on add as new query, and you are going to see that I have a new query inside this area, and which says adana001mysharepoint.com. All I need to do is that I just need to double click on this area, and you are going to see that the query has been converted into a proper table. If I want to include the other file, the second file, then I just need to repeat the same process. I will go in the area next to the 1998, right click, click on add as new query, and then I just need to double click on this area, and I am going to find that the query has been now converted into a proper table structure, and I can see the file. So I can see both my files from the folder in this area, and now if I want to perform other operations, I can come to this area and I can perform the operation. So this is how you can use the SharePoint folder connector to connect to any folder inside of SharePoint, and you can bring all the contents belonging to that folder, all the files to which are in that folder, to the Power Query Editor. So this was all about connecting to the SharePoint folder in Power Query, and I will catch up with you with the last topic in this Connect to Data Sources series in the next video. Take care.